everybody. Dutch Sense here. 5:57 p.m. Central Time on Saturday, February 6, 2016. And I've got you looking at Earthquake 3D, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. And you can see on the map here right now, a very significant earthquake has struck southern Colorado. We saw, of course, a 5.4 strike this location back in 2011, back when the seismic activity around the planet was under serious unrest. And I think it's prudent at this point to show new viewers, maybe people who are tuning in from the media and other people online, to show you what resides at this location. Now, here's the stats from the USGS. The way we look this up and the way you can do this, get the coordinates from the USGS. Just go ahead and pull them here from their site. Go ahead and copy them. And I suggest you use Google Earth. You'll have to download the Google Earth app. I'll put a link down below to Google Earth and Earthquake 3D where you can get a copy of each for yourself. And you put the USGS coordinates in here to Google Earth. Of course, I've used Google Earth for a long time to show people different oil pumping operations, volcanoes around the world that have shown activity, and it comes in rather handy. It's better than Google Maps, and it's better than any of the other services that we use to look things up. Now, you're going to be shocked. If you're a new viewer, you're going to be shocked to see what's here at this epicenter. Let me just go ahead and show you. Okay, so as this zooms in, let me remind everyone that when we look these earthquakes up, it's important to pay attention to what's around the earthquake epicenter because this can help us to determine what caused the earthquake to begin with. Now, longtime viewers already know kind of what we're looking at here, but let me just back this out a little bit and let the image load. Now, you can see the place marks on here. The reason these place marks are on here is due to previous earthquakes that have struck smaller earthquakes. Here's a 3.1 that struck February 2nd, 2015. And I marked the nearby frack wells that are at these locations. When you see the size of this operation, okay, you can see each one of these different pads. We can zoom in on any one of these, and what you'll see is a wellhead, usually a small frack pond next to it where excess fluids are either pumped in or ejected sometimes. And when you see the size of the operation overall, it goes on for nearly 100 miles from the volcanic mesas over here at the border west all the way to the Front Range. And we zoom back in, and it goes south of the border. This is New Mexico down here to the south, Colorado here to the north. And we were expecting this activity to strike. You can go back and watch the earthquake update video that I made 6 days ago talking about the threat of 4.0 earthquake activity striking across the Midwest. Now, at the same time this is all going on, see all these earthquakes here due east? See the 3.8? Okay, that started out near 4.0. Let's go ahead and open up the stats on this. 3.8, Medford, Oklahoma. We'll do the same thing. We're going to pull the coordinates from the USGS, hit copy. We'll go over to Google Earth and paste them in. And you'll have to take out these little degree signs. For some reason, the USGS symbol here isn't working recently. They'll probably make an update to that in just a little bit. But take out the degree sign, hit enter. So you can see here, here's an oil storage yard, and these are part of a huge pumping operation. I don't have these all marked, but we'll zoom in and show you. There we go, another fracking operation. So several nearby wells, and of course this oil storage yard has a fresh pad next to it, imagery date 2014. This may have been developed into an actual pumping operation here over the past few months or years since this image was taken. But overall, it's part of a huge operation. And we were expecting to see that 4.0 activity across the Midwest this week. And I'll put a link down below to last week's forecast so you guys can see the update and hear why we were expecting the earthquakes to strike here and why we were expecting them to be in the 4.0 range. Again, 4.0, Southern Colorado. Haven't seen an earthquake this size in well over a year, I would say 2 years, maybe three, maybe back as far back as 2011, like I said at the start of the video. So when you see this kind of activity developing, you know there's building pressure on the West Coast. And we're still watching for the next day or two, Pacific Northwest and down here, Gulf of California, for possible large-scale movement to strike. And you have to be aware that that's going on in light of the other activity that's developed out around the plate. Links are down below to the most recent update, okay, guys? Much love.